The EU is coming to the aid of its unemployed citizens. The European Globalisation Adjustment Fund provides for professional training to those who fall victim to major changes due to globalisation and the financial crisis. MEPs have approved the release of €6 million for 508 Greek workers who have lost their work in the industrial bakery sector. Welcome aid for a region suffering 60% youth employment as a result of business closures.
The Globalisation Fund is entitled to spend €150 million per year. €150 million per year is really nothing for the whole of the European Union. But, you know, it's a symbolic gesture. You don't solve the problem, but you send the right political message.
Romanian, Dutch and Spanish workers are also on track to receive support from the fund. All that remains is for member states to give their green light. Stagnant growth, massive unemployment, and high risk of deflation, just some of the challenges which should have been tackled in the next Eurozone summit. They should have, but the meeting has been struck off the agenda. However, in discussions with the Commission and Italian presidency, MEPs underlined the pressing need for Eurozone reforms.
Nous avons 27-28 millions de chômeurs, nous avons un quart de notre population qui est au seuil de pauvreté ou d'exclusion sociale ou en dessous. Et on ne sait pas encore très bien si ce sommet va se réunir, on ne sait pas encore très bien avec quel agenda. Enfin, je me demande parfois si nous vivons dans le même monde.
Has accessing treatment for serious illnesses become a luxury? For a 12-week course of treatment against hepatitis C, patients face costs of between 50,000 to 60,000 euros. MEPs argue the fees are unaffordable and demand action from the Commission against patent abuses.
This problem is particularly acute in countries undergoing austerity programmes, largely because of the cuts to public services across the board, and this of course limits access to healthcare and life-saving medicines.
MEPs want that message to go loud and clear to Juncker's new Commission, which intends to transfer the issue from its Department of Health to the Industry Department.